Here I am discussing about the disconnection of simple ketones and acids. Now, the first target molecule, as we already discussed, that whenever a target molecule is there, then always first of all we have to ask the question to the target molecule, do you have a functional group? The answer is yes. The functional group is a carbonyl group. So this is the carbonyl group. Now, whenever a carbonyl group is there, there are the another option. Either we disconnect a bond here, either we can disconnect a bond here, we can disconnect a bond here, we can disconnect a bond here, we can disconnect a bond here. So these are the four options whenever a carbonyl group is there. So either we can disconnect a bond next to the alpha carbon like this in the direction of alpha carbon, or we can also disconnect a bond in the direction of this carbon. So this is also another possibility. The positive charge towards the carbonyl carbon, that we have to see. It has to be on the carbonyl carbon. Now, the among all these options, that is, these are the four options. The another one option is, whenever carbonyl group is there, we can go with the FGI. Now, whenever a carbonyl group is present in a target molecule, first question that you have to ask to the target molecule, is it attached to the aromatic carbon or it is attached to the aliphatic carbon? Now you can see these two carbon and these two carbon, they are aliphatic carbon. So your answer is it is attached to the aliphatic carbon. So as we discuss among the possible disconnection, now what we are going FGI. What is FGI? We are converting double bond O into hydroxy group. So when you are converting it into a hydroxy group, now this is a new target molecule. So new target molecule, again you have to ask question to the target molecule, which functional group you have. Now the functional group is what? Hydroxy functional group. Whenever a hydroxy functional group is there, again you have to ask, is it a primary, secondary or tertiary? Now it is what? It is a secondary hydroxy group. Whenever a secondary hydroxy group is there, the best method is either you go with the retro Grignard reaction or you can go with the retro reduction reaction. If you go with the retro reduction reaction, then you will get back your target molecule. So for that, we go with the retro Grignard reaction. That means oxygen-hydrogen bond act as a guiding functional group. It disconnect the bond here and then disconnect the bond here. Now you may have a question, why we have chosen this disconnection? The reason behind it, now most of the times you always look at the point that maximum carbons get separated from each other. So 1, 2 and this the aromatic ring, again 1, 2, 3, this is the aromatic ring. So instead of disconnection here, this is the bad disconnection. The reason, one side there are more number of carbon atoms, other side there is less number of carbon atoms. So this care that we have to take during the disconnection. After disconnection of this, it gives CH3, CH2, C double bond OH aldehyde functional group, that is propanol. And this side is, as we already talked about, it is a Grignard reaction. So Grignard reagent, it is PaCH2CH2MgBr. Now you complete this synthesis. Now look at here in this target molecule, the functional group is acid of carboxylic acid. That is the functional group. Now here the functional group is RCOH. So whenever a RCOH functional group is there, again, now this oxygen hydrogen group act as a guiding functional group and it go back to this type of a disconnection. So what is this disconnection? Again, it gives a retro Grignard reaction. So this oxygen hydrogen act as a guiding functional group. So it disconnect like this and go with the Reto-Grignard reaction. So if you are having RCOH group, then always you go with the Reto-Grignard reaction. Now in this slide, what happened? Now what are the, how we can generate a RCOH group by using RMgBr plus CO2. Now RCOH get converted into acid chloride, then anhydride, then ester, then substituted amides, and all these after hydrolysis get converted to COH. So these are the different procedures by which we can convert COH functional group in different functional group, and different functional group get again back get converted into the COH group just by hydrolysis. So this is the order of reactivity. The most stable is this, and this is highly reactive one. Now this is the new target molecule. Now this target molecule, now as we already discussed, whenever a target molecule is there, start asking some questions to the target molecule. Now the first question to the target molecule, do you have a functional group? Answer is yes. It is a nitrogen atom is there as well as carbonyl group is there. So whenever a carbon heteroatom linking is there, there is a carbon and heteroatom linking is there. Always first disconnection is you disconnect at carbon nitrogen bond. So you can see in the analysis, the disconnection is here. A carbon nitrogen, and always the disconnection towards more electronegative atom, as nitrogen is more electronegative as compared to this carbon, therefore disconnection towards the nitrogen, and so it create a nitrogen with negative charge, that is the symphone here, and carbonyl group with plus charge, that is the another symphone over here. Nitrogen with negative charge, always remember that nitrogen is a donor, just so simply place the hydrogen, and this carbonyl group with positive charge, that means you have to write down the leaving group. So first synthetic equivalent of this CO plus is COCl. As we discussed already in the previous slide, that COCl is obtained from what? It is obtained from the COH group. So once you have written COCl, then write down FGI and write down then COH group. Now what type of this functional group is created now? This is an example of RCOH group. Just in the previous slide, we already discussed when there is a RCOH group, the best one is the you go with the Reto-Grignard reaction. So disconnect the bond in the direction of alkyl group. So carbon dioxide, and this one is the Grignard reagent. Now Grignard reagents are obtained from what? Alkyl halide plus magnesium. Now, so this is the alkyl halide. So alkyl halide, again, you have to write down FGI, and alkyl halide is converted to OH. So alkyl halides are obtained from alcohols. Alcohols are treated with PBr3 and get converted into alkyl bromide. Now this is the new target molecule. If it is a new target molecule, then what we have to ask again to the target molecule? Which functional group? Now there is a hydroxy functional group. What is the specificity of that hydroxy group? It is a secondary hydroxy group. So whenever a secondary hydroxy group is there, always what you have to go with this? Again, it is a Reto-Grignard reaction. So oxygen-hydrogen bond acts as a guiding functional group. You disconnect a bond here and then disconnect this bond in this way. Now again the same question, why we have chosen this bond, why not this? So again you can see 1, 2, 3 carbons are over here, and this side also 1, 2, 3. So you always remember the disconnection is maximum carbons get separated from each other. So here is the best disconnection. So from here, it gives what? Propanol plus propyl magnesium bromide. How do you get a propyl magnesium bromide? From propyl bromide. So look at the synthesis graph. This is propyl bromide, treat it with magnesium, then attack it on propanol, and after hydrolysis, you get this. Then a hydroxy group get converted into Br, by using PBr3. Once it gets converted to alkyl bromide, then treat it with magnesium metal, get the alkyl magnesium halide, and then treat it with carbon dioxide, and after hydrolysis you will get this COH functional group. Now COH functional group, as you know, hydroxy group is not a good leaving group, so we had to convert OH into a good leaving group. That's why we had to treat it with the thionyl chloride, so it get converted into COCl. Once it get converted to COCl, then we have to treat it with piperidine and get the target molecule. Now sometimes the target molecule not having any functional group, that means the target molecule is a saturated target molecule. So look at this target molecule. Now in this target molecule, the once we already discussed, that is whenever a target molecule is there, we have to ask the question to the target molecule which functional group. Now here we become a handicap. As there is no functional group, so what we have to do? Now, if there is no functional group, what you have to do? We have to go with the FGI. That means we have to add the functional group. So which functional group is added? A double bond is added. Whenever a double bond is there, I already said, that is whenever a double bond is there, you ask the question to the double bond, is it a part of a ring or it is outside of the ring? As it is outside the ring, therefore what we have to prefer? A retrovittig reaction. So we have to prefer a retrovittig reaction. So at one side it is a vittig reagent, other side it is a carbonyl group. So this one is the bad one, that is placement of hydroxy group here, it is a bad one. So whenever a saturated target molecules are there, always, most of the times we have to place a double bond, and then accordingly we have to see whether we have to follow the vittig reaction or we have to follow the dehydration reaction. Now this is again one more target molecule where there is no functional group. If the functional group is not there, now again what we have to do? We have to add the functional group. Now the addition of functional group is the double bond. Now there are the so many options of addition of double bond. You can add double bond here, you can add double bond here, you can add double bond here, you can add double bond here. So among these four options, which position is selected? This position is selected. What is the reason behind it? The newly introduced double bond is in conjugation with the phenyl ring. Therefore, this double bond having more stability as compared to the placement of double bond here, placement of double bond here, and placement of double bond here. So now, once the double bond is there, again, our questionnaire starts. Is it a part of a ring? It is not a part of a ring. So the answer for this, it's not a part of a ring. So what we have to go? Again, we have to go with the retrovittig reaction. So vittig reaction, we have to follow that route. So the one side is vittig reagent, other side is carbonyl group. So one side is pH, this is a vittig reagent, and this one is the carbonyl group. In the synthesis part, that is, vittig reagents are obtained from alkyl halide. So PaCH2Br, treat it with triphenyl phosphine. The base is used, base abstract this proton, and then it get converted to vittig reagent. And after getting vittig reagent, then it attack it on the carbonyl group. So the double bond fixation is possible. And once you get the double bond over here, now look at the target molecule, there is no double bond. So what we have to do? We have to reduce this double bond and get the target molecule. Now in this example, again, there is no any functional group. So if there is no functional group, now again we have to add the functional group. Now which is where we have to add the functional group? Now this is the branch point. So this is the branch point. So always, first of all, locate on the branch point. So which is the branch point? So this one is the branch point. So near the branch point, you have to add the functional group. So either you place here or here, they are one and the same. So first is again a go for FGI. Once it gives a double bond at the branch carbon, So always remember the placement of double bond is at the branch carbon, as well as this newly introduced double bond is in conjugation with this. So placement of double bond always near the branch point. Now double bond, again the question arises, is it part of a ring or it is not a part of a ring? Now here answer is, it is a part of a ring. So whenever it is a part of a ring, you have to go with the dehydration reaction. So what is dehydration reaction? Dehydration reaction means you have to add the water molecule. So water molecule you have to add, that means at one carbon there is addition of hydrogen and the other carbon there is a hydroxy group. We already discussed that the addition of hydroxy group is always at a hindered carbon. So this is more substituted carbon as compared to this. Therefore, hydroxy group we attach on this more substituted carbon rather than this one. Now, this is a new target molecule. Now, if it is a new target molecule, again the same question. Which functional group? Answer is hydroxy. Specificity. Its specificity is what? Now it is a tertiary hydroxy group. Whenever a tertiary hydroxy group, 100% you go with the retro-Grignard reaction. Sorry. So hydroxy group acts as a guiding functional group and disconnect this bond. Now you may have a question, why we have not disconnected this one? The reason behind it, don't disconnect the ring bond. That's why we have to disconnect this substrate. So it gives what? Cyclohexanone plus phenyl magnesium bromide. So go for the synthesis. Phenyl bromide, treat it with magnesium metal, then treat it with cyclohexanone. After hydrolysis, you get this. Then phosphoric acid, that is the dehydration. After dehydration, you'll get a double bond here, and the double bond gets reduced by the reduction reaction. Metal reduction reaction. Next target molecule. So this is the new target molecule. Now in this target molecule, you can see there is a presence of a functional group. A carbonyl group is there, as well as nitrogen function. Nitrogen is also there. So whenever a carbon heteroatom linking is there, always remember you have to disconnect a bond between carbon and nitrogen. And this disconnection is always towards the more electronegative nitrogen atom. So first you disconnect carbon nitrogen bond. After disconnection, it gives CH2 NH2, and this side is what? CO plus. CO plus, plus means the leaving group has to be there. So COCl, and COCl is obtained from what? Acid functional group. So it is directly written over here. It is COH group. Now next, that is this CH2NH2 group, that is this CH2NH2 group. This CH2NH2 group is obtained from, that is a FGI. It is obtained from cyanofunctional group. Cyanide, if you reduce the cyanide group, it gives CH2NH2 functional group. Now in the next one, now this one is written as converted into this cyanofunctional group. Now this cyanofunctional group, now here, what we had to do, now this group is getting added by this way of disconnection. That cyano group always carry a negative charge, best one. So go for this disconnection. After disconnection of this, so CN minus, that is the synthone generated here, and that CH2 plus. Whenever CH2 plus is there, the best disconnection is, the best synthetic equivalent for this is the hal placement of leaving group. So CH2 plus, the best synthetic equivalent for this is CH2Cl. Now how do you obtain CH2Cl? This CH2Cl can be obtained by formylation reaction in presence of HCl. So formaldehyde in presence of HCl. Now start the synthesis. So start with this one. Treat it with base, NaOH, then treat it with dimethyl sulfate. Treat it with dimethyl sulfate, then convert OH into a methylation. So OME group, then do the formylation reaction in presence of HCl, so that para position of this methoxy group, it gives a CH2 Cl group, then treat it with sodium cyanide. After treatment with sodium cyanide, that Cl minus attack here and depart the leaving group. So it gives CH2CN. So CH2CN after lithium aluminium hydride reduction reaction, it gives CH2NH2. Then the hydrolysis of cyano group, a basic hydrolysis, it get converted to COH group. Then oxacyl chloride, treat it with a oxacyl chloride, it gives COCN. And then combination of these two gives the target molecule. Now this is one of the well-known drug, that is a brufen. Now in this case, again you ask the question to the target molecule, which functional group? The answer for this is a COH group. Now whenever a COH group is there, the first question you have to ask to the target molecule, is it RCOH or it is RCH2COH? Now what is that? There is no in between CH2 group. No, there is no in between these two CH2 group. So it is an example of RCOH. Whenever there is an RCOH group, always go with the retro-Grignard reaction. So go with the retro-Grignard reaction. So disconnect here in the direction of this. So get the alkyl magnesium halide and then get the alkyl halide. So Br plus magnesium. Then what? That Br. Br is again, we have to go with the FGI. Replace the Br by OH. Again, OH is there. You ask the question to the target molecule, is it primary or secondary? But you can see that this is attached to the aromatic ring. So whenever it, now it is what? Secondary hydroxy group. And whenever a secondary hydroxy group, there are two options. Either you go with the Grignard reaction or you can go with the retro reduction reaction. So instead of Grignard reaction, the preferred route is, the preferred chosen route is the what? A retro reduction reaction. What is the reason behind it? The reason behind it, as it is an aromatic ring and next to that carbon having a carbonyl group, so we can go with the retro Xc acylation reaction, that is Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. So instead of going with the Grignard reaction, secondary hydroxy group, go with the retro reduction reaction, that means FGI instead of OH, now write down the double bond O. Now, whenever there is a double bond O, then what we have to again ask question to this target molecule, whenever double bond O is there, is it attached to the aliphatic carbon or it is attached to the aromatic carbon? Now you can see it is attached to the aromatic carbon. Whenever it is attached to the aromatic carbon, the best disconnection is retro FC acylation reaction. So you disconnect this bond in the direction of phenyl ring, so it gives what? Acetyl chloride plus this minus charge, aromatic ring with minus charge. Aromatic ring is a donor, so don't write, just simply press the hydrogen there. So this plus acetyl chloride plus AlCl3. Now in the next one, now here again what we have to do, this we have to go for it. Now it is a saturated hydrocarbon. Whenever a saturated hydrocarbon, what we have to think generally? A placement of functional group. Now here, instead of placement of double bond as a functional group, what we have to go in FGI, we place the carbonyl group. Now once you place a carbonyl group, now again you can go with the retro Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction in the direction of this bond. So you have to start the reaction for the synthesis, that is benzene. So start it with benzene, treat it with this acid chloride in presence of AlCl3, get this, then the reduce this double bond O to CH2 group by Clemmensen's reduction reaction, and then again you treat it with acetyl chloride in presence of AlCl3. So as the alkyl group is electron donating group, therefore it activates para position. So Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction takes place at para position. Get this double bond O and then you reduce it with sodium borohydride and then treat it with PBr3, it gives Br. Then treat it with magnesium metal, get the Grignard reagent, and then attack it on the carbon dioxide, and that gives the final target molecule as a butane. Now in this target molecule, again there is no double bond. There is no any functional group. So of course we have to think about the placement of functional group. Now which functional group we have to place? Now you can see here, now aromatic ring is there. Whenever aromatic ring is there, the best we can go with the FC, that is a alkyl side chain is there. And it is a branch side chain. So we have to first of all focus on this side chain rather than this methyl group and this methyl group. Whenever aromatic ring with a branch chain, then we have to think about which functional group we can add. We have an option of either placement of double bond, or we can have option of placement of a hydroxy group. A placement of hydroxy group, you may have a question where to add. Now, this is the best position to add the functional group, that is OH at this group, because after that we can go with the retro-Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. Now here, after placement of hydroxy group, this hydroxy group is what? Again, it is a tertiary hydroxy group. Whenever it is a tertiary hydroxy group, you go with the retro-Grignard reaction. So disconnect this bond in the direction of this group. So it gives what? CH3 plus, this is isopropyl magnesium halide, and then now again it is a retro-Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. So here you disconnect this bond. It is what? Retro-Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. Now look at the synthesis. In the synthesis, you start with this. Treat it with acetyl chloride in presence of AlCl3. Both the methyl groups are donor, so it activates the ortho and para position. So get this COCH3 group, introduction of this COCH3 group. Then treat it with isopropyl magnesium halide. It attack on carbonyl carbon. Then hydrolyze it. You get this. Then treat it with H+. So what it gives? A removal of water molecule, that means you get olefin double bond, and that double bond has to get reduced it with the metallic reduction reaction, and it gives the target molecule. Now up till now what we discuss, whenever a ketone group is there, which questions you have to ask to the target molecule? Whether that keto group is attached to the aromatic carbon or it is attached to the aliphatic carbon. If it is attached to the aromatic carbon, then go with the retro-Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. If the keto group is attached to the aliphatic carbon atom, then always you go with the retro-base catalyzed alkylation at the alpha carbon atom. Now, in case of acid, you always talk about which functional, whenever acid functional group is there, then your first question asked to the target molecule, is it RCOH or it is RCH2COA? Now, whenever RCOH group is there, you always go with the retro-Grignard reaction. And if it is RCH2COA, then it is retro-base catalyzed alkylation at alpha carbon atom. That means where we have to disconnect, if it is RCH2COH, then we have to disconnect the bond next to the alpha carbon. So this is a alpha carbon. So always remember the negative charge towards the alpha carbon is the best one. So once you disconnect the bond in the direction of alpha carbon, then it gives what? R+ as a one synthone, and CH2COH- is the another synthone. R+ is what? It is Rx. And CH2-COH, the best synthetic equivalent for this is diethyl malonate. So remember, the synthetic equivalent for minus CH2COH is diethyl malonate. So acid functional group is there. These are the two options. Either it is RCOH or RCH2COH.